Today, I want to talk to you about the time when Peter so clearly proclaimed Jesus. It's in this great chapter, Acts chapter 2. I'm going to read to you verse 22, which says this. Men of Israel, again, these are the words of Peter speaking to a crowd. Men of Israel, hear these words. Jesus of Nazareth, a man attested by God to you by miracles, wonders, and signs, which God did through him in your midst, as you yourselves also know. Now, as Peter preached to this large crowd in Jerusalem on Pentecost, he began by explaining the strange sights and sounds that the crowd saw, that they were actually evidence of an outpouring of the Holy Spirit. Peter explained it by quoting passages from the Bible. And this was remarkable. In the midst of a great outpouring of the Holy Spirit, when there were signs and wonders and speaking in tongues, what did Peter do? Essentially, he said, let's have a Bible study and let's look at the prophet Joel. In fact, in his Acts 2 sermon, Peter quoted from three different Old Testament passages, Joel chapter 2, Psalm chapter 16, and Psalm 110. Now, this focus on God's word did not quench the move of the Holy Spirit. Instead, it fulfilled what the Holy Spirit wanted to do. All the signs and wonders and speaking in tongues were preparing for this work of God's word through the preaching of Peter. Yet, when Peter finished explaining the Joel chapter 2 passage, he wasn't finished with his sermon. He said to the crowd, "Men of Israel, hear these words." Now, there's some people who think it would be enough for Peter to stop after that quotation from Joel, considering all that we have in it. After all, the prophet Joel told us of an outpouring of the Holy Spirit, of miraculous dreams and visions and prophecy. He told us of signs and wonders regarding the day of the Lord, and he told us about an invitation to call on the name of the Lord and be saved. All of that is in the passage that Peter quoted from Joel. And as great as those things all are, they weren't enough, because Peter had not yet spoken about the saving work of Jesus Christ. You see, you could say that everything up to this point had been an introduction, explaining the strange things that they just saw. Now, Peter would bring the essential message to the crowd, saying, "Men of Israel, hear these words." Peter had already said something like this at the very start of his sermon. Verse 14 says that he said, "Let this be known to you and heed my words." But Peter, throughout his sermon, he wanted people to pay attention, and he spoke as if he had something important to say. You know, that's something that some preachers fail to do. So after the second introduction, if you want to call it that, in verse 22, Peter spoke some essential words. He proclaimed to them, and I'm quoting the verse now, "Jesus of Nazareth, a man attested by God to you by miracles, wonders, and signs, which God did through him in your midst." You see, understanding the prophet Joel and the work of the Holy Spirit were both good and they were important, but it was still essential to proclaim Jesus Christ. We long to know more of God's word, and that's good. And we long to experience more of the move of the Holy Spirit. That's great. But we can never neglect the essential proclamation of Jesus Christ. He is the Savior of the world. So find a way to tell someone about Jesus today.